West is gaining the reputation of being overdeveloped. Too many cars, too many hotels, not enough green space. But this week we spoke to two city leaders who have decided to unlock a well-kept secret.
About a city which is dying of thirst for green space. Here it is.
Key West's forgotten Central Park. Over 200 acres of pristine conservation land, swamps and rivers hiding smack in the center of town. How's that possible? Well, there is a reason why so few know about the gigantic park. There is practically no way to get to it. It is blocked by the airport runway on one side and by residential neighborhoods and high fences on the rest of its borders. There are only two ways in, an unassuming cement road or a small canal through the mangroves. It is a strange place.
Look at this. When this was a Hawk missile site, these here are where the radar towers were.
40 acres is occupied by a decommissioned missile launch site, still spiked with the ominous remnants of a war that did not happen. But in 1962, 90 miles south of Key West, that war turned from cold to red hot and nearly destroyed us all. The rest is a jewel of mangrove mazes and bird rookeries. The question is, what could this park bring to the people of Key West, to their families, and how?
August 15th.
They could, the engineer will tell us how much would it cost us to run a pipe all the way out there. If we do about sewer paths and things in there where people can walk, you know, and sightsee and walk through there and put It's really a rural area right in the middle of the city.
The missile site was donated to the city by the federal government in 2002. It's the only part of the park that has significant upland. In the past, portions of the decommissioned missile site have been used for a paintball field, a model car race course, and as a police dog training facility.
And you don't really have enough big a field for a full-size soccer field. I mean, listen, if they wanted to take this shit out of here and put grass, and kids could practice soccer or lacrosse.
So it's a good practice field.
Sure, why not? It's a waste.
But environmentalists have expressed concerns about the use of grass fertilizers near the salt ponds. But preserving the history of the site is also a concern.
Refurbish and put two radar balls, take that in an open building, maybe put a couple, you know, Hawk missile things.
Very much like in the current situation with North Korea, in 1962, the American public became aware that Fidel Castro had allowed the Soviet Union to install long-range nuclear missiles in Cuba.
Kennedy then made a big speech about considering this a threat, direct threat to the United States. And he proceeded to order a blockade of Cuba, naval blockade of Cuba.
The standoff brought the world to the brink of nuclear war.
Carry what was going on there in 1960 with President Kennedy,
yes,
and Fidel Castro in Russia.
And, in Key West, the U.S. Army set up headquarters at the Casa Marina. Anti-aircraft Hawk missile batteries were erected along the shore. Battery Bravo was set up in the salt pond area and remained there until 1979.
People living in Key West at the time were scared that they were going to get killed.
not too much, because the missiles that you were talking about, the long-range missiles, couldn't shoot to Key West.
So what Russia had in Cuba couldn't shoot to Key West.
No, but it turned out, we found out later, they did have tactical nuclear weapons in Cuba, the Russians did. battlefield, which meant they could have.
So they could have.
Their commander on the ground was authorized to use their nukes. If we had used our missiles, they would have used their nukes. They had them.
The official version has been that President Kennedy's uncompromising position prevailed. But many believe that good old-fashioned compromise thwarted nuclear war.
We agreed, you know, that we would take out some of our missile sites in Turkey or somewhere out over there. We'll get out of there if you get out of Cuba. In other words, that was aimed right at Russia over there. And so we didn't want something aimed right at us right down here. So you take the ones that are aimed at us up over there. So we agreed to strike a deal secretly. We didn't. And they got out of Russia or
good
got out
thing.
Of Cuba. Yeah, with Trump, we'd probably be in war.
Huh?
On August 15th, the city will reopen the debate about the best use for the area. But while the country is again facing a missile crisis, this time with North Korea, preserving the lessons of history could be more important than ever. For a few weeks in the fall of 1962, history pushed Key West to the forefront of a possible nuclear holocaust with Russia. And somewhere in the mangroves of the salt ponds, Hawk Missile Battery B was ready to fire the first shot of the end of the world.
Know that the spades are the swords of a soldier. I know that the clubs are weapons of war. I know that diamonds need money for this art. But that's not the shape of my heart. He may play the jack of diamonds. Space. He may conceal a king in his hand while a memory of it fades. I know that the spades are the swords of a soldier. I know that the clubs are weapons of war. I know that diamonds mean money for this art. Not the shape of my heart. That's not the shape.